Welcome to the third of our three videos of worship for the 10th of July 2022. This first hymn, based on the Bible passage which we've had today, is really an introduction to the intercessions. Paul says he prays for the people at Colossae. Well, here's a way of us praying for the people who are with us in our journey and are in the churches today. Our prayers of intercession are going to be led for us by Linda today.
Almighty and most merciful Lord, we come to worship you this morning in a belief that you will always hear us when we pray to you. Help us to really want you to be the centre of our lives and to be prepared to show our love for you in the way we behave towards other people. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Dear Lord, our government has been in a turmoil over the last few days, ending with the resignation of our Prime Minister. Some people are feeling bewildered, let down, or both, and others are jubilant that now a better government may be put in place. We pray that as the government rebuilds itself, it will be made up of people who really care about the lives of others. A parliament that is willing to make decisions that help all people have an acceptable standard of living. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, all over this world, this wonderful world that you gave us, there is war, abuse, and cruelty. We pray that the people of Ukraine will be able to stop the onslaught of the Russian army and somehow a solution will be found to end this war. We continue to pray for India and Bangladesh, where the early monsoon storms caused widespread flooding, where many people lost their homes and some were killed. The floodwaters have now receded, but there is now more risk of waterborne diseases. We pray, Lord, for access to clean water and protection after illness. In Ethiopia, where there's been so little rain for years now, food and water shortages have increased even more. This extreme poverty has caused a massive increase in child marriages. We pray for the aid workers struggling to find adequate food for families tempted to sell their daughters. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Dearest Lord, please inspire us as to how to solve our roof problem, so that this church can continue to serve its parish and attract people to do great and wonderful things in your name. Please make us better people, more considerate towards others, more honest with ourselves, and more faithful to you. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Dear Lord, we pray that your spirit of healing will flow down upon all those who are ill or lonely or unhappy. So let's just sit for a moment in quiet and picture in our minds those that we know who right now needs God's loving touch. Please bless these people we have been thinking about and enfold them in your peace. We pray for all those who have a loved one who's died. May your spirit of comfort be with them. You know how we grieve for our loved ones, how angry and resentful and lonely people can become. Please help those who are grieving to know that you are close by them, reaching out to them to comfort and support them. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We also pray for those of our congregation who can no longer worship with us, those who are housebound, dependent on family, neighbours or carers, and for those who are now in care homes because they are physically frail or their memories are failing. Please help those who are exhausted with caring to trust you in all the different parts of their lives and truly believe that you are in charge and that ultimately all manner of things will be well. Please strengthen them by your spirit and help them to feel you close to them. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Rejoicing in the fellowship of Saint Luke and all your saints, we commend ourselves and the whole of creation to your unfailing love. Merciful Father, accept our prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
A shortened version of the Collect for the fourth Sunday after Trinity. O God, the protector of all who trust in you, without whom nothing is strong, nothing is holy, increase and multiply upon us your mercy, that with you as our guide we may pass through things temporal and lose not our hold on things eternal. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And please join us as we pray the Lord's Prayer together.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
At the end of a service focusing on the fact that we have been called and chosen and transferred into a kingdom, let's remind ourselves of the nature of the God of love who has done this out of the generosity of his own heart. God is love. Let heaven adore him. And so may God keep us certain of his love. May he keep us mindful of the fact that we have been transferred and bought onto his team with a big transfer fee in order that we can play our part in making the world a better place for him.
May the Lord bless us and preserve us from all evil and keep us in eternal life. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God.